Students, welcome back to the online classes. I hope you all are safe and sound. Today we are going to start with the second chapter, that is Introduction to Rational Numbers. And the very first topic is natural numbers and whole numbers. Most of you know what are natural numbers and whole numbers. So let us revise it again. Numbers starting from 1 to infinity are called natural numbers. Example 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 till infinity. What are whole numbers? Numbers starting from 0 to infinity are called whole numbers. Example 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, dash, dash, dash to infinity. Or in another way, we can say that if we include 0 in front of natural number, it will become whole number. Let us come to another topic, that is integers. What are integers? Negative of natural numbers together with whole numbers form the set of integers. Negative of natural numbers. Whatever the natural number is, it should be negative. Negative of natural number plus including whole numbers. The combination of negative of natural numbers as well as whole numbers together forms a integer. Over here, some of the integers I have written: minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, dash, dash, till infinity. This should also be till infinity. I hope it is clear to everyone. Let us start with another topic, that is rational numbers. What are rational numbers? Any number that can be expressed in the form of A by B or A upon B, where A and B are integers and B is not equal to 0, is called a rational number. Let us take an example of 5 upon 4. It is written in the form of A by B, where B is not equal to 0. Suppose if I am going to write 5 upon 0, whether I can define it is a rational number? No, it cannot be defined. So that is why a condition is given over here: B is not equal to 0. I hope it is clear to everyone. Let us come to another topic, that is terminating and non-terminating numbers or decimals. Let us take an example so that it should be clear to you very much. Over here I have taken an example of 5 upon 2, 17 upon 5, 18 upon 50, 8 upon 15, 9 upon 20, 17 upon 6 and 11 upon 21. They are the fractions. Now if I am going to divide all the fractions and I am going to get the answer in decimal, if 5 upon 2 is divided, I get a decimal 2.5. 17 upon 5, I get a decimal 3.4. 18 upon 15, I get a decimal 0.5333. Over here you can see 3 is repeated again and again. So that is why I have put a dash. It means that 3 is repeating again and again. 9 upon 20 can be written as 0.45. 17 upon 6 can be written as 2.83333. 3 is repeating again and again. That is why I put dash, dash, dash. After that, 11 upon 21 can be written as 0.523809, dash, dash, dash. Again, the number 523809 is repeating again and again. Now, how you are going to find out whether the given fraction is a terminating decimal or a non-terminating decimal? Let us explain it with the help of a trick. Leave this part. Just see the denominator of each numbers, each fractions. 5 upon 2, the denominator of 5 upon 2 is 2. After that, 17 upon 5 is 5. 18 upon 15 is 15. So 15 can be written as 3 into 5. 9 upon 20, so 20 can be written as 2 to the power 2 into 5. 17 upon 6 can be written as 2 into 3. And 11 upon 21, so 21 can be written as 3 into 7. Now, after writing the denominators of each fraction, you have to reduce it to its prime factor. I have already reduced it to its prime factor. Now what is the trick? Listen it very carefully. If the prime factors of the denominators are 2 or 5 or both, it is must that the denominator are 2 or 5 or both, then the decimal is terminating. Otherwise, it is non-terminating decimal. This is the condition for terminating and non-terminating decimal. With this condition, easily you can find out whether the given fraction is terminating or non-terminating. I hope it is clear to everyone. Let us start with another topic, that is equivalent rational numbers. Before explaining you equivalent rational numbers, I will explain you equivalent fraction. I hope most of you know what are equivalent fraction. Over here you can see two diagrams, the shaded portion and unshaded portion. It makes 1/2, or it is equal to 1/2. This can be represented as 2/4. I have to find out whether these two fractions are equivalent or not. So let us see how we are going to make it. If we multiply both numerator and denominator by 2, we get what we will get. 1/2 into 2/2 makes 2/4. Or if we divide both numerator and denominator by 2, we get 2/4 divided by 2 divided by 2 is equal to 1/2. So you can easily see that both the numbers are equivalent. So we conclude that if we divide or multiply same number by numerator and denominator of the fraction, the values remains the same. It will not change. Therefore, in the same way, if we multiply or divide same number by numerator and denominator, the value remains the same. Now let us see what is equivalent numbers, rational numbers. Let us see with the help of an example. 2/3 is a rational number. If we multiply it by 5, we get 2/3 into 5/5 is equal to 10/15. Over here I am getting a result as 10/15. If I am going to simplify it, it will become 2/3. If we divide it by 5, we get whatever result I am getting over here, 10/15. If we are going to divide it by 5/5, what I am going to get? 10/15 divided by 5/5 is equal to 10/5 divided by 15/5, or it will be 2/3. Therefore, we can say that they are equivalent rational numbers. Let us see another example. Write 5 equivalent rational numbers of 4/6. If I have to write 5 equivalent rational number of 4/6, how we are going to write it? 4/6 into 1/1 is equal to 4/6. 4/6 into 2/2. I am going to multiply both numerator and denominator with the same number. It will become 8/12. When I am going to simplify it, it will become 4/6. 4/6 multiplied by 3/3 makes 12/18 is equal to 4/6. 4/6 into 4/4 makes 16/24 is equal to 4/6. And 4/6 into 5/5 makes 20/30. When I am going to simplify, it will become 4/6. I hope it is clear to everyone. Let us start with another topic, that is positive and negative rational numbers. Over here there are 4 condition and 4 case, which I am going to explain you with the help of an example. Let us see the first case. Over here I have taken example of 5/6. Over here you cannot see the sign, so it can be written as +5/+6. Now if I am going to find out the sign, it will be sign of a rational number will be plus. Second case, over here I have taken an example of minus 4 upon 7. So it can be written as minus 4 upon plus 7. So sign of rational number will be minus. Third case, example 6 upon minus 8. So it can be written as plus 6 upon minus 8. Therefore sign of rational number will be negative. Fourth case, minus 5 upon minus 10. So it can be written as minus 5 upon minus 10. So minus minus cancel. So sign of rational number will be positive. I hope all the topics are very much clear to everyone. Next time when we are going to meet, I am going to start with another fresh topic. Till then, be safe. Goodbye. Students.